please stand on our feet and welcome our pastor for today's session.
Can we just speak in tongues for 1 minute?
In the name of Jesus. I remember when I became a Christian really. When I hear my bishop, I say, do ask him every time, so korokoto. I say, this man is crazy. What is wrong with this man? That's what I keep on telling us. You can never ever be faithful until you see the faithfulness of God. You can never. We were taught wrong. We were told, go and stop sinning. Fight not to sin. When sin comes, start fighting. You can never stop sinning. You can never be faithful until you see the faithfulness of God. What we were supposed to be told was go and seek His face. Go and understand God. Study your Bible. Pray for God to help you. Are you getting what I'm saying? So when I was seeing Bishop Edua saying, I started trying it, you know, because everybody is doing it. I was more confused. Koto, koto, rokoto, murokoto. My own is like a trailer movie. Or somebody sleeping in the night and making kroon, kroon, mokoro, mok. I said, this is nonsense. I had some people, if you share their own, tip, 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 mkem, 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 mkem. I said, what is wrong? I became more confused. I wanted. When I had an encounter with Jehovah, shibalaka. When I understood that everything is already yours in the garden, I said, but how will we be communicating? I went to Rehoboam's crusade, and he said, there are a lot of people here that are sick. Those the Holy Ghost just said, allow me to speak to you. Allow me to. And he said, lift up your hand. Holy Ghost, rain upon them. That which is, and there was an encounter. And from that day, I speak in tongues more than my bishop. I speak in tongues more than him. I don't know any other prayer. Say, shekete mokoro, mokoro. That is how to discover God. You can't discover God by working hard. That was what we are told. You can't discover God by, you know, there are people, no knowledge. You discover God by knowing God. And His word says it. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3. Can you read it? 2 Peter. He's with me always. He's with me all time. He's my lovely friend. 2 Peter 1, 3. My Savior all the time, He's with me always. You are with me all time. You're my lovely. Didn't you see it? Apostle Paul was killing the Jews. Apostle Paul was doing all sort of things until he had an encounter. Immediately his mind changed. Yeah?
His divine power.
His divine power. Have you seen it now?
Has given us everything.
Has given us everything. Not His divine power that, you know, because we sought to know Him. We sought to see Him. We sought to see His faithfulness and power. And what have He given us?
Everything we need for a godly life.
For a godly everything. You see, you tell it through knowledge. Continue.
Through our knowledge of Him.
Through, you see. Seeking to know Him is that's the pathway to being faithful. Okay, look at what 2 Corinthians. Where are you reading? Second Peter, right? Yeah. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18. 2 Corinthians 3, verse 18. don't know God by working hard. You know God by knowing and seeing His faithfulness and knowing who He is. He is the power behind His word. So yes, are you there?
3:18.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and we are.
We are.
Whom with unveiled face.
If we open and remove the veil that is covering all our eyes,
contemplate the Lord's glory.
Are
being transformed.
Yes.
Into His image with ever increasing glory, which comes from the Lord, who is the Spirit.
You see, another version says that we behold Him in as a mirror. You see now, the way you look at mirror, you see yourself. The Bible is saying, if you look unto God that way, He said, before you know it, you start changing and becoming like Him, from glory to glory. You have another version? How did that version say it?
Oh, I just compare. But we all with unveiled faces,
yes,
given back as in a glass, mm-hmm, the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image.
Read King Light.
But we all, mm-hmm, with open face, mm-hmm, beholding as in a glass.
Beholding us in a glass.
Or the glory of the Lord.
Yeah.
Are changed.
We change. You see now, what changes us? It's beholding. Looking up to Christ, the author and the finisher of faith. That's what changes us. But we were, you know what we are doing? We were, as a baby Christian, go and work hard, make sure, be dedicated, be committed. No. It's knowing Him spiritually. I came to understand this because that was the experience. I started seeing what is happening in my life. Why is it that the same Christianity that is very hard for another person to get results? Why is it very easy for me? I found out that I stopped looking at my leaders and started looking at the owner of the church. Does that make sense? A very powerful lady that has even a bigger ministry than most of us in Australia. God directed her to me. And when I opened her eyes, I said, you are the boss. It's not you thinking because you have a greater ministry. Your ministry is the body of Christ. Our ministry is church. That's why I will be retiring. If it is the body of Christ, no retirement. You have. Just encounter that knowledge. Oh, you need to see her in her glory. You need to see her in doing. And to God be all the glory. Because it has helped me. It's going to help me to fulfill one of my calls. Why God brought me to Australia. Now, we are still talking on the topic of wisdom. Wisdom is not, you know, there are three dimensions of wisdom. Implied wisdom, applied wisdom, personified wisdom. And if you do not allow the Holy Spirit to guide you when you study the Bible, you might not understand which is which. But by special grace, because I've done this exposition on two teachings, when you listen to the first one, and listen to this second one, you'll be able to understand, because I'm going to deal more on the dimensions of wisdom so that we understand the one that is applied, the one that is implied wisdom, and the one that is personal wisdom, personified. I believe God through the scriptures. But I just want to ask a question, you know, and I would want two people to answer me. We are in a war. Look at what is happening. If I tell you that Trump is the will of God, you will not believe me. But it has always been the same from the scriptures. God wanted wanted his children to lead. Israel are rejected and said they needed king. And God told Samuel, do what they want, but they should know that they are asking for trouble. The same way with Jesus, when he was on earth, even the master, the same people he came to deliver were the same people that did what? Crucified him. He killed him. So it's not about what God wants. It's about our choices. Does that make sense? We've made the choice and say it's Joe Biden or whatever. Joe Biden, Obama was showing this morning where he was calling him to show that Joe Biden is his boy. Because he was his assistant. a woman. But I'm trying to tell you the person in charge is Chinese, bigot. Forget about Russia. They have their, they can disappoint anybody anytime. They are, how do I put it? Infugenius of themselves. Mm-hmm. So that is what is happening now, because Bigate works with China. It's easier for him to penetrate with China, infuse the world, you know? So, but I keep on telling everybody that America is not the owner of this world, it's Jehovah. And the foundation of this world is upon the word of God. Mm-hmm. And no man can change it. It's only one God. If we push God, if we put a demand on God, I'm telling you, whatever we want will come to pass. So, who is the word of God that is in charge? Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. The word is good. It's just that when people like Trump are there, it makes a lot of things easy. It makes the good to prosper more. And moreover, the Trump is blessed, because it takes a man that is blessed to lead people to a blessed land. Does that make sense? So, congratulations to Trump. He tried. A whole one man fighting the whole world. You know? But to God be all the glory. But what I'm trying to say, in effect, there's a lot of confusion. Pastor Joseph, yeah. We know, we see the testimony of God upon your life, but we don't believe what you're saying about Trump is true. So if somebody comes to you with that kind of moral confusion and say, please, brother, sister, advise me, because I want to bring something out because of this teaching, wisdom. So what will you advise such person? You know, if you see somebody is your close friend and you don't really want that person to miss it. So it means that your advice has to be sincere. As a Christian, as a born again Christian, what will you advise the person? What will you tell the person in this hour, contemporary, where there is a lot of confusion? You know, you see, I've shared with you a few things that pastors are doing, ministers that people are looking onto are disappointing everybody. Or I was listening to prophets, every prophet where they were showing how powerful they were. Even people, the newscasters were calling them on the media. Who is going to be our next American president? 99.9% they said Trump. They said God, the other one said God came to him as he was walking, and God told him, and God showed him, bid him taking over. And he said, oh God, why? He said, no, bidding is gonna, it's not going to win. God said, bidding is not going to win. That Trump is going to win. But the bidding will go back in shame and go and replan and come back in another evil, genuine way. I was looking at TV Joshua, all of the everybody. What does that mean? They are not hearing from God. They are just intimidating people. They are not. There is a prophecy I shared on my page. May 2018. And it was seen exactly what was happening in 2020 in Nigeria, October. That's prophecy. And the guy will even tell you, because people that see, it's just like when I saw Australia, 2003 of October, 2003. It's just like when I saw Biafra. You can't talk me out of it. I'm not wasting, I'm not like other, I have concrete. And I keep on telling you guys, if there's nothing I've learned from Archbishop, he's patient. I don't care, but what I know, what I see, I saw. There's nothing that will make Biafra not to come. I saw it on the 10th of June, 2015. I saw it. I saw it. This is not, and the first time I said it, you know, people were just, who is this man? Even the church, I told my bishops, I said, you are saying I'm crazy. Watch out, this is time for me to overtake you guys. Because you claim you hear from God. But me, I heard from God about it. You will see that I'm not mad about the Afro. I can't come out and start talking. I can't talk about Trump because God did not show me anything. I can't talk about David, even if you put a microphone on my head, I say I've not seen anything. I'm not that kind of prophet. I'm not pleasing man. So what will you tell people? I want to know. One, voluntarily, then I want glory to share as my daughter that's believing with me. If your friend, one of your friends, your best friend, come and say, Gloria, I know you are a Christian. I know you serve a living God. I have seen in your life, you are not confused. I've seen in your life, you're solid. Whatever happens, you always have the right answer. What is your advice for me to be stable like you? Maybe somebody have to share first. What will you do, any of you, before Gloria will now share? Yeah, quick. Somebody come to you, say you're a Christian, advise me, I'm so confused. What advice will you give the person? Remember, you can find yourself in the desert. If you find yourself in the desert where there is no one really helping you, so it means your own is finished. It's not me. That's why I like pens. For people that are afraid of pens, when they need, maybe there is pain, the first thing they will get confused. But when you know how to enjoy pain, when pain comes, you start asking questions, what am I going to get from this? And that question alone will make the devil, well, am I fighting the wrong person? Because your mind is straight. What am I? Oh, pain, P-A-L, now game is coming. The time game is coming. Stabilizes you. Don't startle you. It will not startle you. It will stabilize you. So, what will you advise your friend? That's the kind of world we are in. Because if you don't know that, you cannot place value on the teaching you're having today. Yes. One person saved us before my daughter will say something. Because she has been living with me. She has been. And I love, oh, you need to hear them when they pray you. Because that's when I know whether they are learning what they have been. Yes, church. Pastor, are you going to deliver us? Music director? Or drama director? Or media director? Who's going to deliver us? Where is Klaus? I saw him teaching on Facebook. I'm waiting for him to see him. Every time he's just disappointing me. Why should we go on public and be kissing? What kind of insult is that? Huh? Don't know how to talk to that guy over there. Was kissing, no married, nothing. This one is now a rainbow gear. Not a Asian. God will help me, this me and this my child though. Yes. Pastor, do you tell him anything? Do you advise him?
Yeah.
That one, what was the recent one? Well, he was eating with one leg. It's not married. Mm-hmm. And he went on Facebook. I've not seen it since that time. Yes. Anybody? Can you share with me what you tell your friend? If your friend run to you. Okay, Glory, what do you say your friend?
If your friend run to you, says nobody wanna support you.
You wanna say something?
Could you like please repeat the question?
It's a question.
No, could you please repeat it? Sorry.
The question I'm asking, we are in a confused world. Everybody, remember, you know, you can wake up like this and be in the desert where there is no police, Australia, a secure nation. It means you are vulnerable, anything can attack you. So does it mean your own is finished? Maybe you wake up and you find yourself in the wilderness. It means you need something if you must survive. Now, what if somebody comes to you, let's say you've passed such a situation and you survived, and somebody came to you and say, Ginny, Giovanni, I see you as a stable person, but I'm confused about this world, about everything about this world. What's your advice for me so that I'll be as stable like you? Or understand, or not be afraid, you know? The way you talk in times and then, you know, that is it.
Well, I think I just quote what you said, you told us once. You said, the best thing to do is just to remember and to understand that the two things that are real in this earth is God and His words.
This year you will never fail in life. Come on, listen. You see that this guy is a gift. He's a gift. Let's be put his heart together for. So Glory, what do you have to say to somebody come to you? What would you tell him? How would you present it to your friend, you know, and say to encourage her to so that she will not be confused. The Bible says, Job, when they come to Job, after meeting Job, the case is closed. So what will you?
Well, adding on to Jimmy, in my perspective as a believer, I would tell my friend that it's not in my place to help you with your confusion if you're not stable. I would say that you have to go to God, Jesus, because he's the only one that can help us. And it says in this verse, I think it's Psalms 71, verse 1, in thee, O Lord, do I put my trust? Let me never be put to confusion. So it's saying here that if I put my trust in the Lord, I'll never be in confusion. I'll be stable.
Can we put our hands together? You see, why is it that I've not gone to Canada? I'm supposed to finish Canada and Israel before my return. We came to Australia, saw the sources. We said, no. What of Malaysia? Until we make sure that Malaysia is stable too, we are not moving further. We will stay in Australia until God changed the story of Malaysia. We can't let boy in Malaysia and we'll just be jumping to Canada without knowing his level of. What does that mean? It's only a fool that will labor and lose what? And now we are rescuing Malaysia. Very soon, Malaysia will be very more comfortable even than Australia. Then now, because Australia will look after itself. I'm telling you, when you guys wake up, want to build your house, want to buy your church hall, you get a grant from government. I'm telling you, you don't have to, otherwise with your papers, you buy any kind of house you want. But it's not like that with Malaysia. So that as we are moving to Canada, I know I have finished Malaysia, I have finished Australia. Concrete. Then when I'm in Canada now, it's going to be easy. And if the one that's going to be just like offensive will be in Israel. Pam! Just within 1 year, 2 years, I'll finish. Because there's already testimony. How will I keep on teaching or moving when I don't see that the people I'm teaching are concrete? Does that make sense? I must make sure, that's why, because the topic I'm dealing on now is number one, wisdom. I'm telling you, if you have, if you understand the implied and practice it, and the applied and practice it, and the person that is wisdom, and understand all this, you can never be stranded in life because you are not alone. The wisest thing, the wisdom of God, everything is already with you. Praise the Lord. We read throughout chapter 8 of Proverbs. We read throughout it last week. And there is no other thing. The reason, one of the major reasons why I wanted us to read that place is to get out, to extract most of the things we are taught wrong. Like, start from 17. Can you get it? Proverbs chapter 8, 17 and 18. See, this is what we have been, the church is preaching. I'm telling you, there are men of God that will go to their church. And I say, I'm not going to talk about money. They will hate me for that. In as much as what I'm going to teach, we make the people to be richer than they were before. I went to Nigeria, I spent almost 10 million naira. I didn't get back an offering of 1 million. I wasn't interested. Today I'm richer than what I should have been. Because it's not sowing and reaping. It's not, it's deception. We are making it, are you hearing what I'm saying? We are removing it as if it's not a relationship with God. It's rather our works. Does that make sense? But we should be a relationship with God first before you come to our works. Yeah, you get it. These are the major things.
Proverbs 8, 8, 17.
17, 8, 17. I love those who love me.
And those who seek me, find me.
Those who seek me shall find me.
Riches and honors are with me.
Are you seeing it now? What do you need to do to be rich? Find him, man. I told you that is where I got this revelation that Our faithfulness doesn't depend on our hard work or seeking or trying to be faithful. Our faithfulness depends on locating, discovering whom Jehovah is, discovering his faithfulness, discovering his holiness, discovering, you know, all these things. The Bible says, as we behold him, we are changed, transformed into the same image. What does that mean? Does it mean if you are now being transformed, maybe you are looking unto Jesus, you have been looking unto Jesus for 10 years, you have been looking unto him, and you started seeing the change in your life. So does it mean if you are not sowing seed, the prosperity sign will not reflect in your life? Everything, the Bible says all things are yours. All things are yours. All things are yours. Those that seek me, see it, 18, what you finish it.
Riches and honors are with me.
Mm-hmm.
Long-lasting wealth and righteousness.
Long-lasting wealth, prosperity, posterity. Go 19.
My fruit is better than pure gold.
No, 21, sorry.
That I may cause those who love me to inherit wealth.
You see now? It didn't say you must sow a seed. Are you there now? Am I making sense? All you need to be prosperous, to be everything. What is prosperity? What is the image? Shalom, peace. You see a man? That's upright. He said his end is peace. He'll be a prosperous man. I found out that I don't even, it's not because of seeing so. My brother, all I do is the need. But we have been karaoke, you know, karaoke, you know, karaoke in music. This is trying to tune out karaoke. We have been karaoke, you know, that's my English, you know. We have been tuned, you know, if you don't understand my karaoke, change it to tune. We have been tuned to believe unless we sue in the church, tied. Of we stopped sending our tithe to headquarters in 2018. We got a breakthrough and needed them to write a letter. And they didn't want to write a letter. The leader said no. Only writing a letter, replying a letter. A breakthrough in Australia. So how are we working towards expansion? How are we working towards? They said no more tithe to their tent. It has no reduce up. But we are what the project we are doing is more than our time, is it not true? Helping the needy, paying churches all over the world, helping the needy. It has not reduced us, right? It has increased us. Why? It's not about the time, your money. No. I changed, that was when I changed. No more seed to general overseer. No more seed to archbishops. Now I'm bishops. No. It's only low bishops that I know that are humble. Because it doesn't bless you anything. The one that blesses you is the one you give to the needy. It's not all those people who bless me so that you be like me. You are a demon. You want me to be like you, God forbid. I'd rather be like Jesus. Oh, you see the grace of God upon my life? Come and sow seed so you be like me. I say, you are not heron. Worm will eat you. The Bible didn't tell us to be like you. The Bible told us to be like, oh, you're looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Are you liking what that's the in Africa? That's their style. Do you see what you are? Do you like what you're seeing? Do you like the vehicle I'm riding? Do you like the private jet I'm riding? Come and so see, so that God forbid you are indeed. In fact, if I in Africa now, thank God for the level he has blessed me. If I see any bishop saying that, I will come out and take the microphone and tell him you are a demon. You are a demon. It doesn't matter who he is. So seek to be like me. So seek to prosper like me. No. The Bible says, do whatever you do to be like Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. So we have been waylaid with some, fraudulent principles in the Bible. The Bible says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness and every other thing, and every, including wealth, including money. I went to the right place, the place you test and find out whether that man of God is genuine. It's when he goes to where he grew up and preach the message he preached everywhere. Because sometimes you can be deceiving people, but you can't deceive people that knew. Before I preached at Abba Bishop, I brought out my people, the people that taught me in Sunday school. I said, can you, if you lie here, this is the altar of God, you know this altar, God will curse you. Say the truth about Idika. Ah, Idika, stubborn man. Idika, this, that. In fact, one time somebody came and said, you know, if this man doesn't, I will kill him. He's a bad man. He's this, that, did that. I said, thank you, my dickie. Tell them the truth. So does it mean I have witnesses? They said yes. Does it mean I was, you know, I was among the chief sinners of my generation? They said yes. From their saying, did I have money when I left Abba Bishop? They said no. Poor as torture. But there was one thing about this guy. If he hears anything from God, he cannot. I said, that's good. If he hears anything, because what has brought me thus far is faith, not money. Believing those things that be not as though they were. Why? Because God has said it. He said, one thing about this guy, if anything God tells him, I said, you have finished preaching my message. So why am I preaching? Why am I saying all these things? It's for you people. You are my brothers. You are my sisters. You knew me from there. And here is our father. He has said about me. Why is it that today I'm different? Why is it? Faith. Faithfulness of God can never fail. As you behold him as in a mirror, as you behold him as in a glass, you will see you start changing. In the mirror, what are you seeing? Christ. As you are seeing Christ, you know, but some people, when they go to the mirror, the Bible says they see and forget what they saw. Those are wavering. They see Christ. No, we keep on looking. Nah, this Christ, the mustache is beautiful. I want to have that kind of mustache. Maybe that kind of mustache that do like this. It's, the Bible says, as you keep on talking about the mustache, his eyes is very beautiful. Oh, you are building a mirror, not yourself. The Bible says, if you keep on doing that for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, 7 years, you see, you start having that old mustache. That blue eyes, the picture you now see, before you receive Christ, but now you start seeing that you have changed. It's no more me that lives, but Christ that now lives in me. That's my secret. When I left Nigeria, in everywhere, I want to see Christ. In every angle, in my marriage, I want to see Christ. My wife will say, oh, honey, in as much as I love you, but whenever you do, it didn't shake me. I said, sweetheart, I'm going to change. Christ doesn't do when you do H-Yam. I'm going to be like Christ. Every situation, my children will say, daddy, no, you're getting it wrong. I will check whether what they're saying is true. Yes, because criticism, if you obey it, you change. You become a better person. It's only the other criticism that kills. That's wisdom. Am I making sense? Now, what is applied wisdom? Applied wisdom is the output. Implied wisdom is the output of applied wisdom. If you apply wisdom, when it works, people will now imply and say, that is wisdom. That means you are implying. Somebody applied wisdom. And the result came out. How do I say it now? In what you're doing, listen, praise came to your house and they wanted to get something out of you. But in wisdom, you were able to answer it so that nobody was hurt. You know, everything, you were able to manage it in that wisdom. And people said, he applied wisdom, right? He applies wisdom before he says something, right? Then when they now see the result, they say, that's applied, that's implied. When you're talking about, look at how wisdom works. You are implying. I don't know what I'm making sense. Now that's these two, forget about it, whether you understand or you don't understand, it doesn't make sense, not where we're going. But we're talking about wisdom, embodiment of wisdom working, wisdom being alive, wisdom being a member of your family, wisdom being, are you getting my point now?
It's not, you know, when we talk about personified, it's living. Living wisdom. Not wisdom that you give somebody the way you give tablet. Okay, you need wisdom in this. You ask liberally and God will give you a tablet. You overcome that. No, we're talking about Jehovah himself. Wisdom, personified. So we're talking about you being the wisdom in Australia. You being the wisdom in your family. You being the Christ. It's just the same thing. It's just that Christ is the New Testament name. And the Old Testament name I'm bringing out. It's so that when you read the Old Testament, you see that they are saying the same thing. There's no two ways about it. Are you ready for us to continue the journey again? I'll show you something first before we continue. Go to Proverbs chapter 4. You know, I like chapter 4 so much. Read verse 1, then you will jump to 7. Proverbs chapter 4. I love it because of verse 1.
Listen, children, to a father's instructions, and pay attention so that you may gain discernment.
You see now, he's talking about listen to what?
Children to a father's instruction.
You see now, the father is talking about is the wisdom. Okay, read the next verse.
Because I give you good instruction, do not forsake my teaching.
Do not forsake my teaching. Now go to 7.
Wisdom is supreme. So acquire wisdom. And whatever you acquire, acquire understanding.
Now listen very well. You see, wisdom, another person said, is the principal thing. See, don't ever start anything in life. Don't ever. You know, there's a scripture that says that the foundation of the law is in his. So that we don't put wrong scriptures. 87 verse 1, Psalms. Just hold that place and flip to that place. Psalms 87 verse 1. In his holy mountain, which means God cannot do anything. Everything he does starts with his holy mountain, the foundation, the beginning.
The Lord's city is in the holy hills.
No, rich King James. That's what it is. Primary school.
It's Psalm or song?
Psalms.
Oh yeah.
87 verse 1.
His foundation is
his foundation, beginning.
In the holy mountains.
The foundation of the Lord. He can't do anything. It starts with his job. Now go back to that Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 7.
Wisdom is the principal thing.
Wisdom is the principal thing.
Therefore, get wisdom.
Therefore, please, I beg you, don't ever leave your house. Don't ever think of marriage. Don't ever think of business. Don't ever think of any other thing. Don't ever think of, I beg you, my children. Don't ever. Without wisdom. Wisdom is the principle. Now listen, the wisdom is talking about there. It's not a wisdom of go and learn. Get the person of wisdom. Make sure that you know wisdom. You have a relationship. You know there is a relationship between you and wisdom. Whose name? What's the name of wisdom in the New Testament? Put it here and say and read it again.
Jesus Christ is the principal thing.
Do you not see?
Yeah.
Is it making sense now? It's not as if Old Testament is different. It's just the words. So read it again. Let's read it. What is making sense? Are you guys enjoying what I'm teaching? Are you getting it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus Christ is the principal thing.
And in all you're getting.
Therefore, get him.
Are you seeing it now? Now, continue, son. You see?
And with all that getting, get understanding.
Understanding means seeing him.
Have an encounter with him. Not just putting. So I'm telling you this. Church, hear this thing I'm telling you. I never knew all these things, but I was practicing all these things practically. It was not when I said, why is it that? You know, people were just confusing me because you are gifted. Your hand, anywhere you go, you prosper. It's a lie. I found out that something God did for me at the beginning of my... In the guy, the principal thing is wisdom. If you don't get wisdom, don't do anything. And how was I able to get the person of wisdom? No reading the scriptures cover to cover. In as much as I was reading it, it was growing. But as I started, anything I see in the Bible, I want to make sure it's my lifestyle. Before you know it, God said, no, I have to take this boy on a journey to wipe away every human wisdom, that nothing is possible, but put the wisdom that everything is possible. And I started, first of all, found out I'm ready. In any level, I see that this is not in line with the way Jesus did his life. And I was ready to fight him. God said, let's go on a journey. Continue. Let's get to 8 before we move.
Exalt her, and she shall promote thee.
You see now, exalt her, and she shall promote thee.
She shall bring thee to honor.
My God. Do you now see? What are you supposed to do for God to exalt you and bring you to honor? Seek first the kingdom. Exalt her. Continue.
When thou dost embrace her, she shall give thee, she shall give to thine head an ornament of grace. A crown of glory shall she deliver to thee.
A crown of ornament, a crown which is wealth. Well, these things are wealth. These things are wealth unto. So after now, will you make sowing and reaping the only way to prosperity? The only way to prosper is seeking first the kingdom, honoring him, exalting him. Let's do a journey. Let's go to our test case. Proverbs chapter 9. Let's start from verse 1. You know we did chapter 8 from verse 1 to the end. Let's continue. Let's do chapter 9 now. Start from verse 1.
Wisdom has built her house.
The person, that is why the Bible says, in all thy getting, this is the one he has built. And he not only built, he brought out 7 pillars. Continue.
She had hewed out her 7 pillars.
Mm-hmm.
She had killed her beast.
Mm-hmm.
She had mingled her wine.
Nothing will stop you. That's what he said. Every beast, no power will stop you. Continue.
She had also furnished her table.
Mm-hmm.
She had sent it forth her maidens.
Mm-hmm.
She cried upon the highest place of the
Now, city. Let me tell you something about maidens. Anytime you see, in other words, when God tried to use maidens, you have maidens. More especially when he says that those maidens are wearing gold of Ophir, O-P-H-I-R. It means wealth unto. If you have maidens that are on gold, it means wealth. It means you will never lack any. You know, you are so rich if your maids are wearing gold of Ophir. So that's what he's talking about here. Read it again.
She had sent forth her maidens.
Mm-hmm.
She cried upon the highest place of the city.
Child.
Whoso is sinful, let him turn in hither. As for him that wanted understanding, she said to him, Come, eat of my bread, and drink of the wine which I have mingled.
Now, is this not the same thing the Bible says in Isaiah chapter 55? Is it not the same thing? Read it, chapter 55 verse 1. Hold on, sorry, you're going back to this. Come, eat of my bread, and drink of the wine. Yes? And you be there, Isaiah 55 verse 1. What is it?
Oh, everyone that thirst,
mm-hmm.
come ye to the waters.
Mm-hmm.
And he that hath no money, come ye.
You don't need wisdom. The 10 most important things in life, you don't need to buy it. It's free. Wisdom, number one. You know that it's free. He said, come.
Because go back to Proverbs. I just want to show you that this is scripture compared to scripture. Just say the same thing. Yeah. Proverbs 9. Are you, where are you now?
Verse 6.
Okay.
Forsake the foolish and the and go in the way of understanding. He that reproved a scorner getteth to himself shame. He that reproved a wicked man getteth himself a block.
Yep.
Reprove not a scorner, lest he hate thee. Rebuke a wise man.
That's implied wisdom. Wise man. That person is wise. He are blind. So you are not implying that that man, you know. But that's not the wisdom we are talking about. We're talking about the person of wisdom. Continue.
Rebuke a wise man, and he will love thee.
Mm-hmm.
Give instruction to a wise man, and he will be yet wiser.
Wiser. He will get more tablet, you know. Yeah. Give him tablet, you know. When you see somebody that is taking tablet called wisdom, give him more tablet, and will get wiser. Does that make sense? So means he's getting it. But that's not the wisdom we're talking about. We're talking about when you appear, wisdom appears. We are talking about, are you getting it? And that's the wisdom, even if they throw you here and throw you into the desert, you can never be stranded because you are embodiment of wisdom. Christ in me, what? The hope of glory. Can you never be confused? One of the things that challenges him now in life, if people call me and tell you this is true, it started from 2004. I'll say, people, I have a problem. I want to. The person is not laughing at me. I say, the guy that I know, you have a problem of 70,000 naira. I don't even have 500 naira to solve the problem. But I want to solve a problem of 70,000 naira. 2004, people were telling me face to face, and they were laughing at me. You, the guy. We that when we have problems like this, we come to you for wisdom. Oh boy, go, you are just wasting your time. Only 2 days, 3 days, you know what to do. And it has been happening till now. When I wanted to marry, it was as if I was foolish. My leaders, I asked them, go, this is my wife. When I came, they were running away. When everything finished, they said, we know you are wise. We know you know what you're doing, but the problem is, we talk together. This is your money in the royal family. And you gave us only 1 naira to go. When I got there, I said, all my in-laws, everybody, come and show me the Bible. You know I'm a pastor. Show me the Bible where God said I must pay money to marry, to avoid fornication. Oh, you want me to go and start committing an adultery? A pastor of fornication? You must tell me the Bible, then I will pay you the money. I'll come with what I have, my daughter. And she woke up. People will just say, one pastor said it in Malaysia. He said, when he came here, we were asking him, how are you going to build your church? He said, my father, Archbishop, he said, sir, we build church for people and give it to them. He said, this is my turn to enjoy it. And people say, are you sure? He said, my father, he had been sowing seed. Now it's time for me to leave the seed. He said. And the man said, the unbelievable part of it is, as he's saying it, it's like a magnet. He's gathering people. He's gathering people, doing the same thing he's saying. You know, doing the same thing. Before you know, you say, look at it, that's how this place came. He started with saying, I'm not doubting how I'm going to get it. I already know how I'm going to get it. He said, are you going to get it? He said, my father, Archbishop, said, I was Masaka Boya Baba. Is it not where I've stopped that these my children are going to continue? Everything I owe, as long as I live this earth, now belongs to them. They take charge. Glory will not take control 100% when I'm alive, is it not? But if you like that, I'm like that. She will take control of me, how the rapper they will put me. She will decide how to deal with me. If I was a bad daddy now. Are you getting it? But if I was honorable man, you should know my dad in death. We still remain honorable. I can't allow it. Are you getting it? So that's the same thing I did when Archbishop died. I came to Malaysia. I'm in charge. He has been sowing, so it's time. And then you see, that truth of God of Malaysia can never fail because the foundation is on blood of Jesus and on faith. Are you getting it? Let's continue. So where did you start?
Verse 9.
Mm-hmm.
teach a just man, and he will increase in learning.
Mm-hmm.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Have you seen it? The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Oh, I don't know where to start. Get wisdom, get wisdom. If you can get wisdom, wisdom is the way to... How do I get it? The fear. The fear of the Lord also means seek first. That's another way. Seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness and every other thing. Do you understand where I'm going now? The wisdom we need to succeed is not anywhere. It's in the fear of God. It's in referencing God. It's in understanding that He is the author and the finisher of the faith. Continue.
And the knowledge of the Holy is understanding.
You see now, did I mention it already? The knowledge of the Holy is what?
Understanding. Mm.
But to somebody that is not holy, knowledge is knowledge to the person. But a holy person is not knowledge, there is a divine revelation. Continue.
For by me, that is...
He has started that. He now want to show himself. He said what?
For by me that days shall be multiplied.
By me that days shall be multiplied. Continue.
And the years of that life shall be increased.
I can make your life, I can make you live forever. Yeah, 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 yeah. Who has this power? Who has the power to say, it's only Christ, no man. That's the wisdom personified talking now. Continue.
If thou be wise,
mm-hmm.
thou shalt be wise for thyself.
Mm-hmm.
But if thou scornest, mm-hmm. thou alone shalt bear it.
Mm-hmm.
A foolish woman is clamorous.
Mm-hmm.
She is simple and knoweth nothing.
Yeah.
For she sitteth at the door of her house and on a seat in the high place of the sea
mm-hmm.
to call passengers
mm-hmm.
who go right on their ways.
Yeah.
Whoso is simple, let him turn in hither.
Mm.
And as for him that wanted understanding, she said to him, stolen waters.
Listen very well. Stolen waters are sweet.
Are sweet.
Bread eaten in secret is pleasant. Continue.
But the knowledge, but he knoweth not that the dead are there and that her guests are in the depths of hell.
Now, what is he saying? See, there's a way that seemeth right unto a man. But the end is there. But when you have wisdom, when wisdom is with you, let's go to 24 from verse 3. To settle. It will close. Yeah.
Through wisdom is in house building.
Are you getting it now? How many of us want to build? How many of us want to build? You know, everything, you build everything, I'm telling you. You build absolutely everything. You build, do you know you build your love for your spouse? Do you know you build your love for your children? Do you know everything is nothing on earth? If you want to, everything you have achieved is you build it. Prosperity, you build it. Everything. And the Bible says, before you ever think of any building, think wisdom first. Just like when you want to marry, you are thinking of building a home, is that not? But God is saying, do not ever take a step without wisdom. In all. And it's not the wisdom of tablet, the tablet. You know, wisdom giving you part of his tablet for you to be wise. No. Wisdom himself. If you have that wisdom, do you know the next thing? Everything you do, you ask yourself, if it was wisdom, which is Christ, that is now in my position, which you know that is now living in you, how am I supposed to treat Jimmy? How am I supposed to treat my businessman? How am I supposed to build my church? How am I supposed to build my business? You know, that's all you need to be wealthy in life. To have honor in life, to be honored, that's all. Remember, he said, do you think we are getting it? Because from by next week, I will start, next Sunday, I'll start teaching, bringing out the pillars of wisdom. So what you'll be doing is, you merely will bring one pillar, you check your life. Am I standing on this? If I am not standing on this, it means that the wisdom in me is not personified. It's not the person of Christ. It's tablet. I'm just having some tablets. And when people see you walking with tablets, they will say implied. That's implied wisdom. You having the tablet is applied wisdom. But now that's not the wisdom. We're talking about the person of wisdom that can say with me, is enduring which riches. And it's no, you're not limited to just applied and implied wisdom. You can also be that wisdom personified. Because it's, I am crucified with Christ. It's no more me than you, but Christ that lives in me. Why not be that wisdom for your family? Why not be that wisdom? People have lived, died, but still today they are still being remembered. Because it wasn't them, it was wisdom. And when Jesus was alive, the Bible said, the wisdom of God. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I want to achieve. Are you there? 24 verse 3. Have you seen?
Yeah. Through wisdom is in house building.
Now you want to build. If you bring in wisdom, the house is have started building. Yes?
And by our understanding, is it, it is established?
If you see wisdom, understand wisdom, you start establishing it.
And by knowledge, shall the chambers be filled with
updates. Updates. As you keep on working with him, you see all the inside will be filled.
Your precious and pleasant riches.
Yeah, continue, son. Go to 7 and then we'll finish.
A wise man is strong.
A wise man is strong. You're not lacking anything. Continue.
Yeah, a man of knowledge increases strength. For by wise counsel, thou shalt make thy war. And in the multitude of counselors, there is safety.
Safety, you are safe. Now listen, is it 7, is it 9?
Wisdom is too high for a fool.
You see now.
He opened not his mouth in the gate.
A fool cannot even compare. A fool will say there's no, there's no. Do you not see? There's a place if say the fool says there's no God. Look at Mary, 25, 24. Either 23, Psalms 23 verse 1. Or Psalms 24 verse 1. Read it, you get it. The fool says in his heart that there is no God. You see the same thing. What chapter 1 verse?
Oh, you said Psalms
23 verse 1 or 24 verse 1?
24 says, the earth is the Lord's.
No, then it's 23.
Verse 1 states, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
Psalm
14:1. Read 14:1, but it's 20 something. It's not, it should be 20. 21.
Yeah, one is right. Yeah.
41, okay.
Yeah. The fool had said in his heart, there is no God.
See? There's another one. You see, they said it so many times at the beginning of the verse. So, 14 verse 1, you see, the same way, wisdom is too high for a fool. Too high. You see, some people, you tell them, this is possible. Or this, they say, just, you know, say, I'll finish talking, I'm done talking. If there's nothing you say, and when you say, you answer you. Because a fool knows everything. You see, the story of my children, I'm telling you this is very true. It's good. When they will be sharing with their friends, or giving testimony, or sharing about me, my wife, you will see they start from the area of weakness. And boom, they will come to the area of strength. When you see my dad at home, he behaves as if he cannot even. But if there's any issue now, you see him very tired. When you see him at home, you see, you guys, you think, this is not the way my dad. You see him just one corner in his room. He's with his God. See this man, you see that he's behaving like this. He's not like that. Doesn't have time. Just him and his God. A man of wisdom is a man of strength. But you don't waste your time. You don't. And the strength of a man of wisdom is patience sometimes. My mom said, did you, are you getting me? I want you to grab not just the implied wisdom or applied wisdom. I want you to be the wisdom of your generation. I want you to be the wisdom of your family. And in my next teaching, you start checking yourself whether you are truly the wisdom of your family. Everything my mom was saying about me when she was alive, she changed my name to leader. You are the leader. When I was robot, leader. I'm not scared of it. I'm not going to, you know, when you talk about this, people will say, my wife is a living witness. My family members, they tell her. It's not, you know, my younger sisters, my younger, when they tell her stories about me, all these things can happen in your life if you pursue wisdom. And you get what I'm saying now. Let's try and see Proverbs chapter 2, from verse 1 to 6, then we'll close. I promise you, we're not going to do that. We'll close. I'm even going to close my Bible now. Proverbs. How do you find wisdom? What are you supposed to labor for to get? Yes, read.
My son, thou will receive my words and hide my commandments within thee, so that thou incline thine ear unto wisdom.
Incline thy ears unto wisdom. My son, if I give you $1 million, it will not be enough. But if I give you this importance, if you will incline, if you will accept this, continue.
And apply thy heart to understanding.
Apply thy heart to understanding.
Yea, if thou criest after knowledge.
Don't cry for money. Don't cry for what the world cry for. Cry for knowledge. Continue.
And lift up thy voice for understanding.
If there's any time you're lifting up your voice, let it be for understanding.
If thou seek her as silver.
If you seek her as the way the world seek silver.
And search it for her as for he treasures.
The way they see, you know, you see, you know, pirates, they will have one eye, then they are still looking for one eye, pirates, and they are still looking for treasure. Every time, you know, captain, what's the captain, Peter Pan and the captain, treasure hunter. What's the name again? You don't want to help me? Captain Hook. So that Jimmy, so that I'm not saying Jimmy watches Captain Hook. See, if you seek it, and what will happen?
Then thou shalt understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God.
So how many of us are ready to throw away everything to seek for only one thing, wisdom? It's the principal thing. In all you're getting, Indica, if you don't get wisdom, you fail. In all you're getting, get wisdom. In all you're getting, get wisdom. If you don't get wisdom, forget it, you're finished. What inheritance is Bible expected, I mean expect fathers to give to their children? Inheritance is wisdom. A good father gives inheritance or leaves inheritance for his children, wisdom. You really love your children and you want to give them the best.
and you didn't give them wisdom. You gave them money. You gave them tickets to cinema. You gave them. Can you believe since I came to Australia, I'm not taking my children to cinema? I was just telling my wife, I said, these are the areas I've failed. And I promise you, I'll take you guys to cinema. You decide the movie we are going to watch. Eh? Sorry for the long delay. Because I've already been giving them wisdom, 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 wisdom. But they still need to enjoy at least me with them. Well, that's why I like Bishop Fredado. When I was telling him all the exploits I did in Malaysia, I was giving you. At the time he was happy, at the time he became very sad. I said, Daddy, where are you? You see, all these exploits you did in Malaysia, did you take your children to cinema? I said, no, I didn't have time. All these exploits, did you ever take them to at least to relax in a hotel and cool your head? She said, don't try it in Australia. Don't try, don't be too heavenly. Forget the real people that are supporting you physically. So that you see all your exploits, I like it, but this one you failed. I said, thank you, Father. I said, I'll do it. I like your exploit. I like, but don't neglect your family again. No wonder when I'm in Australia, your wife is, you know, when I'm here, because you guys are busy. You say, tell your wife, one day I want to meet her. So anyway, to God be all the glory. So he told me that your family is important as your ministry too. Don't just tell me all this for what you've done. Even God himself will not be happy with you. So all this Malaysia was just hard knock to crack for your family. Don't do it here in Australia. That's why when I drive them, we go to Babadulu. Go to all this, I started doing it. And it's working. It's working. You know? When we went to Malaysia and came back, this one, so when they say aeroplane now, it is Malaysia. Don't ever, ever let the first step you take in anything you want to do be wisdom. And you see your life. Don't forget, money is a defense. Wisdom is a defense. In Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 12. But the difference between money and wisdom, the money will save you in the day of trouble. I mean, wisdom will save you, but money will not save you. Stand up, church. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you. May the Lord give you peace beyond your understanding. May the Lord make you an eternal excellency. Your wisdom shall promote you. Your wisdom shall bring honor to you. Your wisdom shall prosper you. Your wisdom shall look and bring you to safety. In the name of God the Father, the Son and the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.